好的。
Hello, dear friends. Good evening. 好的，经常有小朋友们，经常有朋友们要求我来用中文念书。那咱们试试看，好不好？这是极乐世界的清晨，佛祖独自在莲池边散步。你看，真的像极乐世界这么漂亮，这个花儿画的这么好，对不对？这个边上有一点重重的颜色，每一个的这个勾线都很清楚。佛祖一个人在那里走来走去，走来走去。水池中莲花盛开，每一朵都好像玉石一般晶莹洁白。这些莲花这么漂亮，但是这个颜色有一点粉了，对不对？佛祖看到这些花儿这么漂亮，这么晶莹，这么干净，金色的花蕊送出淡雅的清香，那种香气简直难以形容。哦，你看这个倒影，佛祖在池边站了一会儿，从覆盖水面的莲叶之间往下窥看，原来天国莲池的底下竟然是地狱的最底层，第十八层。水晶般的池水像一面镜子，把地狱里刀山火海的可怕景象反映出来。刀山火海，十八层地狱。佛祖看到一个名叫犍陀多的男子和其他罪人在地狱里挣扎。佛祖记得犍陀多虽然是个杀人放火、做过许多坏事的大盗，但他以前曾经做过一件好事。一件好事。原来，当犍陀多年轻的时候，有一次经过一座森林，看到路旁有一只小蜘蛛正在爬行。犍陀多抬起脚，正想一脚踩死这只蜘蛛，忽然念头一转，不可以，这蜘蛛虽小，到底也是一条性命啊，残杀无辜的生命怪可怜的。于是犍陀多便抬起脚，没有踩死那只蜘蛛。佛祖想起犍陀多放走蜘蛛的事，他想，尽管犍陀多做的只是一件很小的好事，仍然值得鼓励。我应该奖励他，把他救出地狱。哎，说来真巧，佛祖转过头，就看到脚边 有只蜘蛛，它正在翠绿的莲叶上吐着美丽的银丝。于是索佛祖轻轻拿起蜘蛛吐的丝线，从莲花中向遥远的地狱垂下去。另一方面，犍陀多和罪人们正在地狱的血池子里挣扎。黑漆漆的地狱里，偶尔有些光亮，也只是刀山剑树发出来的冷光。四周宛如坟墓一般的死寂，只能听到罪人发出的叹息声。不过，落到这个田地的人，大都已经受尽地狱的折磨，疲惫不堪，恐怕连哭出声音的气力都没有了。即使是大道犍陀多，也只能像只临死的青蛙，在血池里，一面吞着血水，一面拼命挣扎。这时，就快放弃希望的犍陀多抬头往上一看，只见无声的黑暗中，一缕银色的蜘蛛丝从天而降。那根细丝仿佛怕被人看到似的，只有细细一根线闪烁着微光，恰好从他头上笔直地垂落下来。犍陀多心中暗自高兴，他想，假如我能抓住这根蜘蛛丝，努力往上爬，就能够逃离地狱之海。啊，说不定还能爬进天堂呢。这么一来，我就不必再被逼着爬刀山、下水、下雪池了。于是犍陀多赶紧伸出双手，牢牢抓住蜘蛛丝，拼命往上爬。对原本是大道的他来说，手脚并用的往上爬并不是一件难事。然而地狱与天堂之间何止千万里，因此尽管犍陀多心急，却不能轻易地爬出地狱。他爬了一会儿，便感觉得累得手脚都发麻，不得不停下来喘口气儿。他悬吊在半空中，往远远的下方望去。总算没白费力气，刚才还浸泡着的血池，不知何时已隐没在黑暗中，那发出寒光、令人害怕的刀山剑树，也已经在脚下。犍陀多想，如果我一直往上爬，就可以逃出地狱了。他将两手绕在蜘蛛丝上， 开心地哈哈大叫起来，我得救了。自从进了地狱后，他好几年都不曾发出这么大的声音。就在这时，健陀多忽然注意到蜘蛛丝的下端有数不清的罪人，他们像一行蚂蚁跟在自己后面，也一心一意地攀爬着。看到这个情景，健陀多又惊又怕，他瞪着眼睛张大了嘴，心想，这么细的蜘蛛丝光自己一个人拉就已经快断了，现在那么多人抓着往上爬，万一中间断掉，不是连辛苦爬到这么高的我都要一头钻回地狱里面去了吗？健陀多着急地想，真糟糕，不赶快想个办法，蜘蛛丝就会断成两截儿，我又会掉进地狱里面去了。于是他暴喝一声，嘿，你们这群罪人，这根蜘蛛丝是我的，谁让你们爬上来，赶快滚下去，滚下去，滚下去，滚。话才说完，方才还好端端的蜘蛛丝竟然扑的一声从吊着剑陀多的地方断裂。剑陀多像个陀螺咕噜噜翻滚着，咚的一声栽进黑暗的深渊。唯有自极乐净土垂下的蜘蛛丝，短短一截儿，闪着一缕细细的荧光，飘垂在没有星月的半空中。佛祖站在莲花池边，凝视着整件事情的经过。当剑陀多像颗石头般跌入雪池时，佛祖的脸上忍不住露出怜悯的神色，然后开始踱步。原来在佛祖眼里，剑陀多只顾自己脱离苦海的行径，实在是太自私，也太没有悲慈心了，没有慈悲心了。剑陀多受到应得的报应，才会再度跌回地狱。不过，莲池里的莲花并不理会这些小事，那洁白如玉的花朵掀动着花瓣，在佛祖脚边摇摆，金色的花蕊送出淡雅的清香，那种香气简直难以形容。这时已接近极乐世界的正午， 芥川龙之介，在罗生门。芥川龙之介，日本著名小说家，也是大正时代文坛的代表性人物。1892年出生于东京，出生后不久，因母亲发疯，因此由母亲娘家养大。母亲的疯病和他的养子生涯，对芥川的人生及艺术创作有极深远的影响。1914年。啊，罗生门 ，yes， 啊，芥川龙之介，啊，正好，正好，正好。哦，哇，哇，哇，哇。芥川龙之介， I do not know his name. His name, he wrote the book 罗生门, who got the Oscar Prize. This is a beautiful morning in Shangri-La. The Buddha was walking in the Buddhist, in the Lotus Park. Along the lotus pond, and the lotus was blossom, and every single flower is crystal pure white, and there is the fragrance, a light fragrance, Indescribable fragrance. So the Buddha was standing at the bank of the lotus pond, and she looked through the leaves and looked down. To her surprise, under the water, the lotus pond, she could see the lowest bottom of l'enfer, of the paradise and the hell, the 18th floor. The water was clear, and she could see through. So here I will add some advertisement, okay? So I am on Patreon, and if you would like to support me so that I can continue to read these books and stories, you can support me. I have different level, whichever one you choose. Thank you very, very much. It's on the first, it's under the description of this video. You can find my Patreon. Thank you. And she could see through, and actually, the water surface was just like a mirror, and she could see very clearly the 刀山火海 the knife, these are knife, the mountains of knife and the ocean of fire. It's just a very miserable and very harsh condition. And she could see people suffering and trying to swim in the blood pond. This is the blood pond. And the Buddha saw a guy whose name is 剑陀多, this guy, 剑陀多, and he was struggling in the l'enfer, in the hell. And the Buddha remembered 剑陀多 was, he was a criminal. He steal things, fire, make fire, and he had done all kinds of bad things. But he has done one thing that is good. He has done one good thing. Once upon a time, many years ago, when he walked in the forest, he walk, and he met a spider. And he was about to step on the spider and kill the spider. And suddenly he thought, well, spider, it is a spider. It's small, but it's still alive. And cruelly kill an innocent life is kind of, you know. So he did not kill the spider. So he left his food, he stepped up his food and didn't kill the spider. And so the Buddha thought about the spider story. So he thought that 剑陀多, this guy, was just the baddest, the worst guy. He was a criminal, but he has done one little, small, tiny good things, and for that, he should be appreciated for this little good thing. So, the Buddha thought, maybe I should save him from the l'enfer. And just at this time, the Buddha turned around and saw on her feet there was a spider was weaving this silver thread, spider web. So the Buddha thought, maybe I should save. So she held up one thread of the silver thread, spider web, and let it drip down into the lotus pond. And inside the pond, the 剑陀多, this guy was suffering with any other people. Everyone was struggling, and they are tired, and they have no energy to cry. And although this guy was a big criminal, but still he had a lot of energy, had done a lot of bad things, but still he's just struggling and almost like a dead frog, almost. And just at this time, when he almost decided to give up and just die himself, he saw a spider web, a silver shiny little, teeny tiny little bit of silver thing. And he looked up, ooh, it's a spider web. Very, very thin thread right above his head. So he was happy. He thought, If I hold this thread and climb up, I can be out of l'enfer, out of the hell. Or maybe I can even go to paradise. And he was dreaming, if I go to paradise, oh, that's so good. So he was a thief, he was a criminal, he has steal things, he has jump roofs. So holding that spider web was not a big deal for him. So he hold it, the thing is that between l'enfer and the paradis, between the hell and paradise, there is a long, long, long way to go. And he tried very hard, but he cannot get completely out of the l'enfer. Anyway, he climbed a little bit, and then he start to find that he's already out of the knife mountain. He's already out of the blood pool, and so he was very happy and he laughed out. And I am saved, I am so happy. And for so many years since he was in the l'enfer, in the hell, he has never laughed, he had never shouted so loudly. And just at this time, this is the spider web, he start to realize, oh, it's not only himself. And he saw a lot of people under. I do not see this picture. I think this is only a spider, but anyway, a lot of people under him. The spider web is so thin. So he was thinking, myself, I climb up. It's already so thin. If it can save me, I am already lucky. And with so many people under me, I cannot be saved. Yeah, I need to think about a method so that I can jump out. I can get out of the l'enfer, and all these people, they will not be with me. I need to kick them out. So he shouted, "You are criminals! Get out! Get out! Get out! Go away! Let me go!" So he said to others, "You are criminal. He is also criminal, right? You must go away." He talked to others. As soon as he said this, the spider web broke. Exactly at the place where he was. Boom. He fell back into l'enfer. He fell back into the hell. The only thing left is the spider web, half broken. The Buddha was at the river bank, at the bank of the pond. She saw the whole happening, the whole incident. And when the guy, when Jiantuoduo fell down to the pond, fell back into the hell, l'enfer, Buddha felt compassion, sympathy, and pity for that guy. And he started to walk around. He started to think, what is going on? And in her eyes, he saw that that guy, Jintoduo, only wanted to get out by himself. He wanted only himself out of the l'enfer, out of the hell. And he did not think about others. He's too selfish. And he has not a sense of compassion, of understanding, of thinking pity for other people. So he got his final revenge. He got back to the hell. Everything come back as before. Lotus pond. Beautiful flower, pure and elegant. And there is still this pale, this indistinguishable little bit, teeny tiny little bit of fragrance. Unspeakable fragrance. This is noontime in Shangri-La. Bye-bye, friends. Here is a little bit of ads. I am on Etsy shop. You can see there are bowls, teas, and some digital downloads. And recently, I am very much into this lemon curd, and lemon curd with different flavor. For example, you can see here, lemon curd, and lemon curd with apricot, lemon curd pure, lemon curd with blackberry, lemon curd with plum. So if you want to support me, this is another way. Thank you very, very much. This is my backyard tree.